Revelation 12, 1 through 10. And a great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was pregnant and was crying out in birth pains and the agony of giving birth. And another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on his head 7 diadems. His tail swept down a third of the stars of heaven and cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman who was about to give birth, so that when she bore her child, he might devour it. She gave birth to a male child, one who is to rule all the nations with a rod of iron. But her child was caught up to God and to his throne, and the woman fled into the wilderness, where she has a place prepared by God, in which she is to be nourished for 1260 days. Now war arose in heaven, Michael and his angels fighting against the dragon. And the dragon and his angels fought back, but he was defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. And the great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent, who is called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He was thrown down to earth, and his angels were thrown down with him. And I heard a loud voice in heaven saying, "Now the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ have come, for the accuser of our brothers has been thrown down." Apocalyptic words like these, captured in symbolic language, leave room for different interpretations, for sure. However, mentioning a pregnant woman who gives birth to a ruler of the nations certainly has overtones that could point to the nativity. Add to that the emphasis of the biblical truth of spiritual warfare, and the night of Christ's birth could have included something like this. In the visible peacefulness of that night, as Mary and Joseph laid their newborn son in a manger, a spiritual battle was no doubt erupting in the heavenlies. Satan knew the prophecies. He knew a Messiah was coming. He worked through Herod to kill every child under 2 years old in an attempt to wipe out God's plan. Yes, the battle lines were drawn out. Weapons were secured. A war waged in the unseen realm between rulers, authorities, and cosmic powers. Soldiers of darkness and evil were against the soldiers of truth and light. The forces of evil were giving everything they had in an attempt to hold on to the darkness. But the light was breaking through, and the enemy would be no match for the light that was to come.